فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد بن عبد الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. My beloved brothers and sisters, the topic that I hope to talk about today is a topic that has and holds a very important message behind it. It is something, with all honesty, that if any one of us is asked this question, can accept and admit it's something that we generally lack, or it's at least reduced in our hearts. And it's the concept of humility, khushoo. So inshallah ta'ala, my topic today, this khutbah, I want to speak about haqiqatul khushoo, the reality of khushoo. And also I want to speak about ahammul asbab, the most important things that a person can take in order to attain khushu'. Ayyuhal ahibba, my beloved brothers and sisters, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in a hadith al-Imam al-Tabarani narrated in his Mu'jam al-Kabir, in hadith Shaddad ibn Awsan radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, that the Messenger said, إن أول ما يرفع من الناس الخشوع. The Messenger said, the first thing that will be uplifted and that will be taken from this ummah is khushu', humility in the salah. Humility is the first thing that this ummah will lose, and it will be the first thing to be uplifted from this nation today that you see. Another narration that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, أول شيء يرفع من هذه الأمة الخشوع حتى لا ترى فيها خاشعة. The Messenger said that the first thing that will be lifted and it will be taken up from this ummah is khushu', حتى لا ترى, until you do not see or do not find فيها خاشعة, a person who has khushu' in his salah. You will rarely come across a person who has khushu', humility with him. And khushu', my beloved brothers and sisters, is عمل من أعمال القلوب. It's an action from the actions of the heart, which one needs to keep with him and has to hold on to. Al-Allama ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyya rahimahullah, he defined haqiqatul khushu', the reality of khushu'. Because my beloved brothers and sisters, the qa'idah muqarrara inda al-usuliyin is, there's a principle that the scholars accept amongst themselves, which is al-hukmu ala shay' far'un an tasawwuri. To place a ruling on something is a branch of a perception being in place. In other words, you can't attain something if you don't really understand its reality, if you don't know what it means. If you have not got the correct understanding of it, then you're not going to give it the right rulings, or you're not also going to come with it as it's required from you. So he defines what khushu' means. He says, khushu' al-iman huwa khushu' al-qalbi lillah. It means that the heart humbles itself for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. In what way? Like in بالتعظيم, by honoring him, seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala majestic and great and noble, والإجلال والوقار والمهابة والحياة. He sees Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to be noble, to be high, to be the one who is in charge of his affairs and to come with humility and humbleness and belittle himself for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he praised the ones who have khushu' with them. In the Quran, he subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says about the noble ones, the prophets and the anbiya, Zakariya and the likes of him, innahum, ayil madhkur, those who are mentioned, innahum kanu yusari'una fil khayrat, wa yad'unana raghaban wa rahaban wa kanu lana khafi'in. Allah says about them that they were ones who came with khushu'. So Allah is praising them for these noble characteristics. In another place, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, إِلَّا الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَالْمُسْلِمَاتِ وَالْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ وَالْقَانِتِينَ وَالْقَانِتَاتِ وَالصَّادِقِينَ وَالصَّادِقَاتِ وَالصَّابِرِينَ وَالصَّابِرَاتِ وَالْخَاشِعِينَ وَالْخَاشِعَاتِ وَالْمُتَصَدِّقِينَ وَالْمُتَصَدِّقَاتِ وَالصَّائِمِينَ وَالصَّائِمَاتِ وَالْحَافِظِينَ فُرُوجَهُمْ وَالْحَافِظَاتِ والذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات أعد الله لهم مغفرة وأجرا عظيما. Allah mentions all of those He has prepared for them. أعد الله, Allah is the one who prepared for them. مغفرة وأجرا عظيما, forgiveness. And from those who are mentioned, والخاشعين, those who have خشوع as a صفة لازمة, a characteristic that doesn't attach itself from them. It does not detach itself from them. Those are the ones who Allah has prepared Jannah for them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven them. And that is something, brothers, I believe what brought you all here today to pray, listen to the khutbah al Jum'ah, to pray the salah, to leave this masjid, is so Allah can forgive you and so Allah can take you to Jannah. And this is the way to attain it, is to have khushu', humility for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rather, the ones whose status, the higher status that they attain in this world and the hereafter, prosperity in this world and in the hereafter, is connected to those who come with khushu'. And Allah gave sifat in the Quran for the mu'mineen, characteristics. That if you open Surah Al-Mu'minun, the surah is called Surah Al-Mu'minun. It talks about the believers and it gives them characteristics that the believers have. Because as Hassan al-Basri said, rahimahullah, al-Iman laysa bit-tahalli wala bit-tamanni. Iman is not something a person comes and he just claims. And it's not something a person just adorns himself. It's not clothes that you wear. But Iman is an action. It's characteristics that have to be found in you. And when those characteristics are there, then you become a true believer. From the characteristics that Allah mentioned in this surah is قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. First characteristics. The first sifa, bariza, the most apparent characteristics. From those characteristics was khushu'. It was nothing else. الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. And it is mentioned khushu', which is amal qalb. It's mentioned with the greatest action of the limbs, which is as-salah. أَوَّلُ مَا يُحَاسِبُ بِي الْعَبْدُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَ الصَّلَاةِ. The first thing Allah is going to judge you for and account you for is the salah. That's the first thing He will judge you the day of judgment on, is the salah. And that action, which is the salah, the first thing that was mentioned next to it, that was attached to it, is khushu'. When the believer reads this, it pops out for him. He thinks, he asks himself this question. What is my salah like? Do I have these characteristics of khushu' in it? Because if you don't, then you lose the ability to be from those who have what? Al-falahu fi dunya wal-akhirah. Prosperity, success in this world and the hereafter. ولذلك, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his companions, were not in Islam for long when they got rebuked for not being with these characteristics. Pay attention to this. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, as-sahabiyul jaleel, the noble companion, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu. ولذلك the ulama, they say, itlaqu, when the word Abdullah is unrestrictedly said, the word Abdullah like that, no one else does it refer to other than Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. There are many other Abdullah. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Abdullah ibn Amr ibn Ba'as, Abdullah ibn Abbas. The first, when Abdullah is said, it refers to Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu. This noble companion said, مَا كَانَ بَيْنَ إِسْلَامِنَا وَبَيْنَ أَنْ أَعْتَمَنَ اللَّهِ. There was not long between when we entered into Islam and when Allah tabarak wa ta'ala rebuked us. And Allah was telling us off based on what? بهذه الآية this verse. ألم يأمن الذين آمنوا أن تخشع قلوبهم لذكر الله وما نزل من الحق ولا يكونوا كالذين أوتوا الكتاب من قبل فطال عليهم الأمل فقست قلوبهم وكثير منهم فاسقون. This was the verse that came down. Some of the riwayat mentions only 4 years we were Muslims and we entered. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he was from what? من أوائل من دخل في الإسلام. He's from the early people who entered into Islam. So you can see straight away they were told off for what? For the khushu' missing from them. And this is the best generation, the most honorable people who walked on the face of this earth. It's the people he himself, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, said, مَنْ كَانَ مُسْتَنًا فَلْيَسْتَنَّ بِمَنْ قَدِمَاتِ فَإِنَّ الْحَيَّ لَا تُؤْمَنُ عَلَيْهِ فِتْنَةً. If you're going to hold onto a people, hold onto that which the companions were upon, because they were the best of generation. They were the ones who were promised Jannah whilst they were walking on this earth, whilst they were alive. All that was between them and entering Jannah was death. بَعَذَلِكَ Allah is telling them off. For what? That the khushu' is not there. It's not fully accomplished. فَمَا بَالُكَ بِغَيْرِهِمْ. Then what do you think of other than them? Us, who are heedless and caught up in the world. So when you enter the salah, a characteristic that you're known for is that your salah is تَأَنِّي وَالتَّرَوِّي وَالتَّدَبُّر. You're thinking, you're pondering on the verses that you're reading. Surah Al-Fatiha is a surah that you recite in every salah that you pray a day. And it is a discussion between you and Allah. This is you and Allah talking. A dialogue between you and Allah. When you say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, in the hadith of Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim narrated in the hadith of Abu Huraira, قَسَمْتُ الصَّلَاةَ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ عَبْدِي نِصْفَيْنِ. I divided the prayer in half between me and my slave. فَإِذَا قَالَ عَبْدِي Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. When the slave says, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Allah says, حَمَدَنِي عَبْدِي. My slave has praised me. So you have understanding of what it means to say Alhamdulillah. That this word, Alhamdu, means Thana'ullah, praising Allah, بِالصِّفَاتِ الْعُلَى, praising Allah for His great, noble characteristics which He holds. So you feel it. You're not just reading these words, and you're not just pronouncing it, but you feel what you're reading. Then the person says, الرحمن الرحيم. Allah then says, أثنى علي عبدي. Then the person says, مالك يوم الدين. Allah says, مجدني عبدي. Then the person says, إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. Allah says, هذا بيني وبين عبدي. And then the person says, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. And then Allah says, هذا بيني وبين عبدي ولعبدي ما سأل. Dialogue between you and Allah. You're talking. You feel it. Your salah is not مجرد الفاظ that come out of your mouth, but it's إشعار and feeling it. That's حقيقة الخشوع. That's the real meaning of what khushu' means. But if you don't understand what you're reading, and you come into the prayer with the idea and the mindset of what? Oh Allah, it's time to pray, huh? Get it off me. I just want the salah to go. I just want to fulfill the obligation. The Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam, he used to find comfort and joy in the salah. He will say, Ya Bilal, arihna bis salah. Bilal, bring us joy and comfort through the prayer. And us, the salah has become an obligation that we want it to go off our shoulders so fast. And when we pray, alhamdulillah, I've got the obligation off. Muslim ibn Yasar, rahimahullah, saqata istiwanuhu, his building, the pillar fell in his own house. It fell and it collapsed. فَاجْتَمَعَتْ عَلَيْهِ النَّاسِ. The people gathered. And he was still in his prayer. Did not move. And he did not feel what just took place. Until he finished his prayer, he saw that the house, half of it was collapsed. How did these people attain that? It's because they knew where the problem lies, which is al-khushu'. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. My beloved brothers and sisters, I want to now go into أهم أسباب الخشوع. What are the prominent things which we can come with? Now we've understood, we've got an understanding of what khushu' means. We've also understood how important it is that we attain khushu'. Now inshallah ta'ala, so that the khutbah is fruitful and it is something that you can live with and it's practical. Let me give you points that you can live with in order to attain khushu'. The first one of them is ma'rifatullah. Knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and knowing who you're standing in front of will allow you, my beloved brothers and sisters, to come with khushu', humility in your prayer in the correct manner. That's why Allah said in the Quran, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Muhammad, know that there is none worthy of worship except Allah. فَعْلَمْ. And ilm is إِدْرَاكُ الشَّيْءِ عَلَى مَا هُوَ عَلَيْهِ إِدْرَاكٍ جَازِمًا. It is to perceive something as it is with unwavering conviction. Having knowledge and understanding of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Ma'bud, the one who is worshipped. Al-Mustahiqu lil-Ibadah, who deserves all forms of ibadah for him alone. No one else. I am standing in front of him. He's the one who brought me into this world. He's the one who runs my affairs. And he is the one who deserves for me to worship him. He's the one I place my forehead on the ground for him in humility, knowing the two pillars that ibadah stands with. Kamalul khudu'i ma'a kamalul al-mahabba. It stands with two pillars. Complete love and complete humiliation. Why else am I humiliating myself and putting myself down for him? I completely love him. I'm in complete love with him. That the person feels those two together. وَعِبَادَةُ الرَّحْمَانِ غَايَةُ حُبِّهِ وَخُضُوعِ قَاصِدِهِ هُمَا قُطْبَانِ. The two pillars it stands on are those two. كَمَالُ الْخُضُوعِ مَعَ كَمَالِ الْمَحَبَّةِ. You come with that when you're standing in front of him subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهُوَ مَعَكُمْ أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُمْ. That Allah is with you with his knowledge. That when you're praying, that you know he knows your affairs inside and outside. That the one you're standing in front of you, يَعْلَمُ خَائِنَةَ الْأَعْيُنُ وَمَا تُخْفِي الصُّدُورِ. He knows what's in your heart. Allah knows what has taken place. What you've just done before you came into the prayer. Allah knows what you're doing now that you're in the prayer. Allah knows what you're going to do in the future. And he even knows what you haven't done. If you were to do it, how you would have done it. That's the one you're standing in front of. That you can't deceive him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the person feels that. ولذلك that's why the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم in the long hadith of Jibreel بينما نحن جلوس عند رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ذات يوم اطلع علينا رجل شديد بياض الثياب شديد سواد الشعر لا يرى عليه أثر السفر ولا يعرفه منا أحد حتى جلس إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فأسند ركبتيه إلى ركبتيه ووضع كفيه على فخذيه وقال يا محمد أخبرني عن الإسلام. And then the Prophet told him about Islam. And then Iman. And then Ihsan. Ihsan, what did the Prophet say? أن تعبد الله كأنك ترى فإن لم تكن ترى فإنه يراك. أن تعبد الله, that you worship Allah كأنك تراه like you can see him. فإن لم تكن ترى, but if you can't see him, then Allah can see you. That is حقيقة الإحسان. So now you know him. He's looking at you. He can see you. معرفة الله is the first thing, my beloved brothers and sisters. The second thing is, for you to come with khushu' is تعظيم, honoring قدر الصلاة. Honoring what action that you're doing right now. This action that you're in is salah. In the prayer and how great it is. ولذلك the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, in a hadith of Imam Muslim narrated in the Sahih, min hadith of Harith al-Ash'ari, radiallahu ta'ala an, that the Messenger said, wa inna Allah amarakum bis salah. The hadith is long. Zakariya ibn Yahya, Zakariya is the one who commanded, إِنَّ اللَّهَ أَمَرَكُمْ. Allah has commanded you this salah prayer. فَإِذَا صَلَّيْتُمْ, if you're praying, فَلَا تَلْتَفِتُوا, don't turn around. Don't look towards your eyes. Don't roll your eyes around. Respect the prayer. Why? فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يَنْصَبُ وَجْهَهُ, because Allah places his face لِوَجْهِ عَبْدِهِ, in front of the slave. The person is standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that he feels that when he's in the salah, that this is what's taking place. And that's what the Salaf of the Ummah, they realized. Ali ibn al-Husayn radiallahu ta'ala anhu, it was narrated, إِذَا تَوَضَّ, if he done wudu, his face will go pale and the color will change. فَقِيلَ لَهُ, he was asked, why is it that your affairs becomes like this when you do wudu? And he says to his family, he would say to them, do you know where I'm heading? Do you know what's needed from me? After I do my wudu, I'm going to be standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in prayer. So he felt that the salah is in front of Allah. Wallahi, thumma billahi, thumma tallahi. If one of you guys were going to a leader today, a person who had authority, a governmental candidate, an individual, a leader, king, president, whatever you want to call it, and you were standing in front of him, you would beautify yourself. You would make sure you look sharp. You would make sure that you, every movement that you do, you're conscious about it. Why is it when you stand in front of Allah, you don't have that with you? When it's the Lord of the heavens and the earth, this is haqiqah, that I myself, the one who's speaking, is the question I ask myself all the time. Why is it that we're like that? The third thing, my beloved brothers and sisters, is tadabbur al-Qur'an, pondering on the Qur'an that you're reading. Thinking, what is it that I am reciting when I read in the Qur'an? Allah says in the Qur'an, لَوْ أَنزَلْنَا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ عَلَىٰ جَبَلٍ لَرَأَيْتَهُ خَاشِعًا مُتَصَدِّعًا مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ. If this Qur'an came down on a mountain, the mountain will crumble. The mountain will crumble from the verses of Allah and His words. Your heart is more harder than the mountain. Ibn al-Qayyim said, Rahimahullah, Rahmatan wasi'ah, if your heart does not crumble and it doesn't humble itself, in this dunya it will forcefully humble itself when it looks at the hellfire in the day of judgment. You choose now the Quran that if it came on the mountain would have felt it. It would have made the mountain move. It can't make your heart more softer than the mountain. It can't move it. The reason is because you don't know what you're reading. Allah says in the Quran, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِنَا قُفَالُهَا. Do they not ponder on the Quran, or are there locks on their hearts? In another place he said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. This Quran that you're reading, why is it that you don't understand it? Ibn Jalil al-Tabari, rahimahullah, he said, عَجَبًا لِقَوْمٍ. May a fascination is with the people. They read the Quran, and they're not pondering on it. They're reading it, they're looking at it, but they are not pondering on it. This Quran that you have, it's talking about qisas, stories here, imam, lessons, durus, ayat. It's talking about ahkam. It's addressing you, each and every one of us. Allah says in the Quran, وَكَذَلِكَ أَنزَلْنَاهُ قُرْآنًا عَرَبِيًّا وَصَرَّفْنَاهُ. مَا مَعْنَا وَصَرَّفْنَاهُ. We have turned the verses for you. Qisas to Nabi Allah Musa in Surah Qasas and Surah Taha, Allah changes the wordings so you may ponder. There's a difference here. Why is this said and why is not here said? All of these changes are taking place, so you ponder and you think and you ask yourself, why is this wording changing here from here? So you're pondering, you're thinking, you ask yourself these questions. But the people who don't understand all of that, then as Allah told us, that is as though there are locks on their hearts. The third is asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and making dua, supplicating to Him. Zayd ibn al-Arqam radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he used to say, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min ilmi la yanfa'. Oh Allah, I seek refuge in knowledge that does not benefit. A knowledge that does not benefit is a knowledge that's only on the mouth. It's a knowledge that does not manifest on your limbs. The ilm is something that you have in your heart. You have in your mind, and it's something that manifests on your limbs. That it changes you for the better. If you're practicing today, and you start to take the deen serious, your family and your neighbors should recognize that you're now a practicing person. How is it? Your family should be happy with you. How our child has become a good person. His manners is very good. He's more tolerant. He's more accepting for his household. But it's sad that when you learn the deen, and you understood the deed, you make your mom cry even more. That you make your family even more upset with you. This is ilm la yanfa'. It's benefit and knowledge that doesn't benefit you. And the second thing that the Prophet said, وَمِن قَلْبٍ, and a heart la yakhsha, a heart that does not have any humility in it. Oh Allah, I seek refuge from you in that. وَمِن نَفْسٍ لَا تَشْبَع, and a soul that never gets full. He's always wants more and more. He's never content. وَمِنْ دَعْوَةِ اللَّهِ تُسْتَجَابُ, and a dua that's not accepted. My beloved brothers and sisters, the best of speeches is that مَا قَلَّ وَدَلْ. It's the best speech is that which is short and gets to the point. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم اغفر لنا هزلنا وجدنا وخطأنا وعمدنا وكل ذلك عندنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا. ربي آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأقم الصلاة.